I used to drag here back in high school. Railroad crossing up there is exactly a quarter mile away from here.
On green, I'm going for it.
You look so excited to talk about this.
I'm distinguished.
For those of you who are looking to win autographed Bills merch, hit up the... That's the Sabres. Oh, yeah. It's an autographed Trey White Goalie Academy helmet. Touché.
But so, I don't know how to do promos.
Go down into the description. There's a link to enter for the autographed Trey White Goalie Academy goalie helmet. Go down, get into it. There's only a few days left. The winner is going to be drawn the day of the Pro Bowl at kickoff. So get in now. The only thing, you're only ever going to see this once. It's a one-of-a-kind item. The Bills are not making this. The Sabres are not making this. Trey White had never seen one when he had him sign it before. So this is a unique item. You want to get your hands on it, go enter now. It's free to enter. I love the fact when people ask for interviews with teams and teams say, nope. Brian Daboll was asked to interview for the offensive coordinator job in New York with the Giants. Here's why I think this is fascinating, right? Who got that job?
Jason Garrett
got that job. Okay. Here's what I think is so fascinating. Jason Garrett was told that he was not going to be the head coach of the Cowboys. Jason Garrett got offered a head coaching interview in Cleveland. Guess what happened? The Cowboys denied his ability. They denied his right to go for the interview because the Cowboys didn't fire Garrett until after the head coaching jobs were all filled. Then they officially terminated him. So he got a request to interview for a head coaching job. The Cowboys still owned his rights and said, no, you can't go. We know we're going to fire you, but no, you can't go. Daboll, similar situation, right? Are they holding on to Daboll just to see what shakes out? Are they really going to go into Daboll next offseason? Because they denied his interview request with the Giants. There are a couple different things. We saw Garrett get denied head coaching interviews when he was certainly being fired. Why did the Bills deny the request for Daboll?
Two words.
Yeah.
Marty Herney.
Okay.
You ready for me to connect these dots?
Please tell me.
Okay.
Like Jon Stewart with the popcorn.
Story time, kids. All right. So, long time ago in Carolina.
Once upon a time.
In Carolina, there was a GM called Marty Herney. All right. Prior to that, he was the director, I want to say, of player personnel. So, growing up in the same system was a young guy named Brandon Bean going through. He was an administrator and he did a bunch of things and all this other stuff. So,
you're so descriptive. Bunch of things, all this other stuff.
I don't know exactly. Yeah, he's got dirt on everybody in the league, I think, with all these deals that he makes. Anyway, Marty Herney, before he ends up getting the job, he was the director of personnel. Brandon Bean is the director of personnel during Marty Herney's tenure.
Right.
All right. So it gets to the point where Marty Herney is going to be leaving and they have to choose his successor. Dave Gettleman, who didn't have any ties to Carolina, comes in and gets the GM job.
Over Brandon Bean. Who had been there forever.
Yes. He was ingrained in Carolina for a number of years. Then, a year after Gettleman's there, Bean is now named assistant GM. We're talking about David Gettleman, who has a GM drafted. His first draft pick was Star Latulewe. Another draft pick, Calvin Benjamin. So there's some hits and misses here. So his first pick was Star Latulewe. Where did he end up?
Well, in Buffalo.
Buffalo. Where did Calvin Benjamin end up?
Eventually in Buffalo.
So who's really pulling the trigger on some of the things that are going on? Now, that all intertwined, we fast forward to today. I'm going to skip over to some of the boring parts for you guys. We had talked about on a previous episode, that didn't have to be such a glorious relationship. Everyone was talking about when the Giants had the number two pick.
The Bills could trade up.
Hey, they got a relationship with them. Gettleman and Bean worked together. not everybody you work with is wonderful. You know, right. that you have a good relationship with.
Especially somebody that took the job that you think you should have had.
Exactly.
Yeah. Not to say that Bean's vindictive, but we've all been in that position where there's a job we think we should be getting, somebody else gets it, and you're not exactly, though, you're not baking this person warm. Cupcakes.
You think that's why, you think there's a kinship between him and Dorsey? So anyway, Marty Herney's the tie between Gettleman and Bean, and that may not have been, you know, too glorious, so, you know, he's like, listen, no, I don't want it, no.
Right.
Listen, you called me about the OBJ deal. Mm-hmm. Remember that a long time ago.
Yep.
I mean, before he went to the Browns, the whole fallout of Antonio Brown happened for the Buffalo Bills. He said he didn't want to go to Buffalo, but, like you said before, on a road trip episode, our other channel, you said, listen, that got him to call.
Yeah.
That got Gettleman to call Bean and say, listen, you want to take this guy off your hands? And maybe, I don't know what was said in that conversation, but maybe it wasn't very pleasant saying, hey, you're not going to take OBJ?
Right.
Which a lot of people in Buffalo want OBJ. But
oh, yeah.
After recent events, you may not.
Maybe not.
All that intertwined. He probably denied it. A, they probably don't want to lose Daboll. They're probably very high on Daboll. And B, he didn't want to give him to Gettleman. And C, what you brought up initially, it is a lateral move.
I mean, it's totally
why would he? If he was going to be the head coach, okay, you're not going to deny a guy that. Okay, he's going to be getting a head job. That's why you coach in this league and do all this other stuff.
Right. Why would you interview for an OC job when you just interviewed for one of the few head coaching vacancies?
Mm-hmm.
Right? Like, just as long as the Bills don't go 4-12, Daboll's still going to be on the radar, on the head coaching radar.
He will.
If the Bills make the playoffs again, Daboll is again on top of the list for head coaching.
He will.
I think it's most fascinating that the request happened because, really, when you look at the court, when you look at the hire, the head coaching hire in the Giants, right, organization, what connections does he really have to people who are available for an offensive coordinator position? Got to be honest, not a lot, right? So a lot of these guys are already, they already have jobs. So I find it interesting that Gettleman felt like he had the cojones to ask Daboll for an interview. Because Dable's got to build the staff. The head coach they just hired with the Giants, he's not building a staff.
Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
The organization's going to have to build that staff for him. Mm-hmm. And that's what I think is most fascinating about the Ron Rivera fallout in Carolina, right? Mm. Think about it, right? Ron Rivera fallout in Carolina. How many of those staffers do you think Bean had a hand in getting in Carolina? You know, from a strength and conditioning standpoint to, a linebacker's coach.
He seems like the overseer of everything.
That's what I mean. I'm very curious to see what staffers from the Ron Rivera camp end up coming over into Buffalo.
I'm sure there will be. I'm sure there will be some that will work.
But again, these aren't things that people are going to hear. We're going to have to tell everybody about it because nobody's the assistant strength and conditioning coach was previously in Carolina. Nobody pays attention to that.
Carolina cracks me up because you have a guy named Riverboat Ron. Carolina's in the Bible Belt.
Sure.
Who do they hire? A coach that preaches the first interview that he has.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to tell you, I'm going to play this.
That's it.
We're going to. But
in Jesus' name.
The Lord is in this car, I tell you.
Lord stopped me from smacking you around a few times, I'll tell you that.
I think common sense did that.
I'm tough in confined spaces.
Do you think that has... Do you think that there's going to be any blowback because of him denying an interview in New York?
No, that might have even been an instance where, you know, Daboll gets the request to interview. Bean and Daboll are sitting in the same room together, and Daboll goes,
no. Is that the Always Sunny?
It is. That's Danny DeVito. Yeah, that's a no. Right? But again, you have to look at the situation. You got a rookie head coach. You've got a second-year quarterback who barely played, and when he did play, wasn't a world beater, right? You got Sterling Shepard as your number one wideout. You got Evan Engram as your tight end. And you got Saquon Barkley. Okay, some nice pieces to work with, right? But ultimately, you've got a rookie quarterback who's got, four games under his belt? And a rookie head coach who is a wide receivers coach?
From where?
From New England.
But that's what I'm saying. He's probably like, hey, Brian, I need some help.
But I am curious to see why he got that request, right?
Because the judge.
Well, and it makes you wonder how secure they feel Dable's job is.
Well,
they just gave the Bills an out. They did, and the Bills denied it.
Yeah.
Because what? But what other options are really out there? I mean, Pat Shurmur, but he just got a job. Shurmur's gone.
It's interesting to see that the Joe Judge does.
Did you see that?
No. Was it?
The Blues Brothers car is parked outside, of course, decades, the smoke shop. The Blues Brothers car is parked outside the smoke shop in Tonawanda on Sheridan.
That's so great.
Well, just after last week.
Yes.
I feel like we need a picture. We'll drive back. We'll go take a picture.
Yeah, we will. I found it interesting that Joe Judge is there, and he was at he was with the Patriots for a number of years. It's almost like you're, like, I wonder if, like, the execs and stuff have casual conversations like you do. Like, hey, I need a guy. I need a paint guy. Oh, I know somebody. Let me call him up for you. You know what I mean? It's like Joe Judge is like, I need an offensive coordinator. Hey, you know Bean, right? Can you call him to see if, like, we can interview Daboll? I know one guy who's very, very happy that Brian Daboll is not going to go to New York and be an offensive coordinator.
Who?
Saquon Barkley.